Senator De Leon is the son of a single immigrant mother. He was the first in his family to graduate from high school and college. Senator De Leon was elected by his colleagues to lead the Senate in 2014. He has led the 40-member Senate body to historic accomplishments that will improve the lives of Californians and the state's environment and economy for decades to come. In many ways, Senator De Leon embodies the promise of America. From a childhood of poverty to community activism to the upper echelon of the California legislature, his respect and commitment to working families and the betterment of all Californians has never diminished.
I'm the youngest child of a single immigrant mother. I can remember taking the number 34 bus. Well, my mom and I would get off the bus and we'd walk up to the homes on top of the hill. There, my mother would spend the vast majority of her day cleaning other people's homes. But it was there where I witnessed the value of hard work. This was a woman who worked her fingers to the bone. She was the woman who put the clothes on my back. So I owe it to this single mother, this woman, and millions like her, you know, throughout the state, throughout the country, who do everything within their power to protect their children. But it doesn't make a difference if it's a Latino African American, if it's white, if it's Asian American, if it's a racially mixed community. Poverty is poverty. And I think that it's incumbent on policymakers, on leaders, to provide real opportunities so everyone can succeed. That's what the country really wants. They want a job. They want a sense of security so they can provide for themselves and their family. If my mother hadn't made that bold, courageous decision to come here, I surely wouldn't be sitting here today talking about what the future should be like for a great state like California.
And we're going to have to fight like never before.
My name is Kevin De Leon, and I'm running for the U.S. Senate in California.
Յուրաքանչյուրիս ձևավորման վրա մեծ ազդեցություն ունի մեր ժառանգությունը, մեր ընտանիքը, մեր համայնքը. Մենք իմաստավորում ենք կյանքը մեր ընկալումներով ու գործերով։ Գործեր, որ կապրեն դարեդար։ Մարդկային հիշողությունը իսկական պարգև է։ Ամեն մի կյանք ստեղծում է իր սեփական ուղին։ Glendale Funeral Home հաստատությունը պատրաստ է ցուցաբերել հատուկ ուշադրություն իր բազմազան ծառայությունների շնորհիվ։ International Families Association is a non-profit organization. Կազմակերպություն, որ տարիներ շարունակ ծառայում է ի նպաստ ցածր եկամուտ ունեցող ընտանիքների։ Յուրաքանչյուր երկուշաբթի և չորեքշաբթի օրերին, կեսօրից հետո ժամը 2-ից 5-ը, տրամադրվում է անվճար ուտելիք և այլ ապրանքներ։ Ընդունվում է ամեն տեսակի հովանավորություն։ Մանրամասների համար զանգահարել 818-770-0779 հեռախոսահամարով։
For advertising on Inside TV, please call 818-653-0199.
Thank you. My name is Kevin De Leon, and I'm the president of the most progressive legislative house in America. I'm running for the United States Senate because the days of Democrats biding our time, biding our tongue, and triangulating at the margins are over. And I'm running because California's greatness comes from acts of human audacity, not congressional seniority. I saw this in the tireless devotion of my mother, an immigrant who chased a better life for her three kids across the border, against a current ethnic bigotry to neighborhood where I grew up just 2 miles away from where we stand today. I'm not just a proponent for the California dream, but I am a product of it. My mother worked her fingers to the bone for everything she had, because I'm here because she refused to wait her turn or to know her place. I'm here because she made California a place of her own. And I followed a path of public service because I believe that every Californian deserves a place of their own. It's been my great honor to lead the state Senate where we passed the most progressive laws in America, the highest minimum wage and toughest pay equity, the most ambitious clean air and climate protections, a secure retirement for millions of workers who don't have one, the strongest gun control laws in the nation. And we carved into stone that no matter the place of your birth or the hue of your skin, you can live in California in safety, dignity, and yes, sanctuary.
Senator De Leon, I would like to thank you on behalf of the Armenian community for everything you've done. Thank you. Thank you for being a friend.
Well, thank you very much. First and foremost, it's an honor to be interviewed by you. And I want to say Barev to all the Armenian American residents, not just of Los Angeles, but the greater Los Angeles County. The Armenian American community is such an important part of who we are in Los Angeles, in California, in the United States of America. And I was honored and proud to be instrumental in establishing the Little Armenia exit sign right off the 101 freeway, because I think what that sign did was, it was more than just a direction. It was the validation and the establishment that Little Armenia is here. Little Armenia is us. We are Little Armenia. And it's part of our community today, tomorrow, and forever. So the 101 Hollywood Freeway sign, Little Armenia, was something that was very powerful symbolically, you know, not just for Armenians, but for all Californians, for all Angelenos. And I was very honored to be able to secure the resources and finally get it done. It had been, you know, in the queue for many, many, many years. And I thought this was ridiculous. Let's get this done and done now. You know, with regards to the independence, you know, of those Armenians, you know, in other parts of the world, in this case, what is happening in Europe today. I've always been a strong supporter of Armenia. I've always been a strong supporter of the Armenian people, wherever they may be. You know, we have Armenians in Iran, and we have Armenians in Syria, we have Armenians in Lebanon, in Russia, and elsewhere. And I always truly believe that the Armenian people should have the right to live freely and independently. And I've always was honored to be part of this political movement. There was a lot of, you know, unrest by political officials, you know, from Europe, but I am honored to have that that opportunity. And the Armenian, you know, museum, which will be established in Glendale. I was honored to actually secure a couple million dollars, you know, this year and last year, so we can help as the seed money to hopefully attract more money from folks so they can actually help participate in making this museum, which will be a validation of the contributions of the economic, social, gastronomical, linguistical contributions, political contributions of Armenian Americans on our lives. The beautiful thing about the Armenian American Museum is that it's not just going to be for Armenians. It's going to be for everybody, whether you're white, whether you're Latino, whether you're African American, Asian American, whether you're racially mixed. Everybody should come to this museum to see the linguistic, the gastronomical, the political, the economic, the cultural, the artistic contributions that Armenian Americans have made. They have made us a much richer, much more diverse community. And that's why I've always been honored and always been deeply proud to represent Little Armenia. And wherever I go, all over the world, when they ask me to describe my district, I just say Echo Park, Silver Lake, Dodger Stadium, East LA, Boyle Heights, Filipino Town, Chinatown. And I said, Little Armenia. I said, Armenians from all over the world, when they come to America, when they come to California, they come to Little Armenia first and foremost. Then when you make a little money and get well established, then you go to other places, whether it's Glendale or elsewhere. But that's why Little Armenia for me has always, I've always held a special place in my heart in Little Armenia. And obviously, the deputy mayor, or the mayor of Little Armenia, has always been Baitsar Tomasian, and Baitsar has been with me from day one, and she has educated me. She has broadened my horizons to understanding the plight of Armenian Americans, the diaspora of fleeing, you know, a government, in this case the Turkish government, and the genocide, the first recorded genocide of the last century, before the Cambodian genocide, before the genocide of World War II. At the hands of the Nazis, before the genocide of the Rwandans, the Hutsis and the Hutus and the Tutsis and other genocides from throughout the world. Sadly, tragically, the first one was the Armenian genocide at the hands of the Turkish government. And this was a reason why Adolf Hitler said that we can move forward with our own type of genocide, because who's going to know about it? Because no one knew about the Armenian genocide. And that's why it is always critically important that we commemorate, that we recognize the Armenian genocide. And that's why I've always been a staunch supporter, as long as I've been state senator and leader of the California State Senate, that, you know, in spite of all the political pressures from Turkish government, from Washington, D.C., sometimes even from our own government, and highly paid lobbyists to try to quash, try to quell, try to censor our ability to commemorate, to recognize on an annual basis the diaspora of the Armenian people from all over the world, and the reasons why the diaspora was created because of the genocide, it's been my deep honor. So I've been always supported by Armenian Americans, and I've always supported Armenian Americans, and will always continue to do so.
Յուրաքանչյուրիս ձևավորման վրա մեծ ազդեցություն ունի մեր ժառանգությունը, մեր ընտանիքը, մեր համայնքը։ Մենք իմաստավորում ենք կյանքը մեր ընկալումներով ու գործերով։ Գործեր, որ կապրեն դարեդար։ Մարդկային հիշողությունը իսկական պարգև է։ Ամեն մի կյանք ստեղծում է իր սեփական ուղին։ Glendale Funeral Home հաստատությունը պատրաստ է ցուցաբերել հատուկ ուշադրություն իր բազմազան ծառայությունների շնորհիվ։ International Families Association is a non-profit organization. Կազմակերպություն, որ տարիներ շարունակ ծառայում է ի նպաստ ցածր եկամուտ ունեցող ընտանիքների։ Յուրաքանչյուր երկուշաբթի և չորեքշաբթի օրերին, կեսօրից հետո ժամը 2-ից 5-ը, տրամադրվում է անվճար ուտելիք և այլ ապրանքներ։ Ընդունվում է ամեն տեսակի հովանավորություն։ Մանրամասների համար զանգահարել 818-770-0779 հեռախոսահամարով։
For advertising on Inside TV, please call 818-653-0199.
Senator, let's talk about your long-time commitment to the increasing access to the environment and, of course, most importantly, immigration.
I think they stand out, but they're inextricably linked to each other. I believe that everyone deserves to breathe clean air into their lungs. Everyone deserves to drink clean water. And I think that the existential threat that's before us is the issue of climate change, and the harmful emissions of carbon dioxide into our atmosphere, as well as other criteria pollutants, NOx, SOx, particulate matter 2.5, the dirty toxins, contaminants that we see in our air that makes it smog, that creates so much asthma in our children in particular. So whether you go to Alex Pilibis School, for example, in Little Armenia in East Hollywood, or to a school in the valley or in Glendale, all of our children suffer greatly from these harmful carbon dioxide emissions, as well as the other types of pollutants that exacerbate their asthma, their lungs. So this is an issue that I care deeply about. I believe that we need to reduce our carbon dioxide emissions, but at the same time create jobs, grow this economy in clean energy, renewable energy, energy efficiency. You know, these are the important policies that must move this nation forward together if we're going to grow this economy, at the same time establish for the entire world that we're deeply serious in the United States of America if we're going to reduce our carbon dioxide. I know we're doing our part in California, and that's why we lead the world. And I've been honored to work with Armenian Americans, very smart folks, scientists, you know, who have presented empirical evidence and data to me that says, hey, we must do something, you know, for our own planet, for our own economy, for our own children. And in the issue of immigration, which is inextricably linked to all of us together, whether you're Armenian, whether you're Latino, whether you're from the Pacific Rim, from Asia or elsewhere, I believe that everyone deserves a right. If they pledge allegiance to the red, white, and blue, they pay their taxes, they obey our laws, they deserve to become full-fledged Americans. We have so many folks who have been here 10, 15, 20, 25 years who have yet to normalize their legal status. And we have a president who has demonized, who has pit one group against another. And I know that Armenian Americans know what this feels like, when you pit one group against another and you demonize a community, a people, a culture, and you go after them for political purposes. So that's why the Armenian American community has always stood proud when it comes to the issue of immigration as well too. And I'm honored to have the support of the ANC, the Armenian National Committee, that has strongly been supportive of my candidacy to be their voice in Washington, D.C., as the next U.S. Senator for the state of California. So if I'm given an opportunity by the Armenian Americans to be their voice in Washington, you will have a strong voice. You will have the strongest voice in Washington that defends the rights of Armenian Americans, not just in America, but throughout the world.
Thank you, Senator, and good luck.
No, thank you. It is indeed an honor. I appreciate it, and for you to come all the way here to the Valley, it's an honor. I'm deeply, deeply appreciative.
We're honored.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I'm the youngest child of a single immigrant mother. I can remember taking the number 34 bus. Well, my mom and I would get off the bus, and we'd walk up to the homes on top of the hill. There, my mother would spend the vast majority of her day cleaning other people's homes. But it was there where I witnessed the value of hard work. This was a woman who worked her fingers to the bone. She was the woman who put the clothes on my back. So I owe it to this single mother, this woman, and millions like her, you know, throughout the state, throughout the country, who do everything within their power to protect their children. But it doesn't make a difference if it's a Latino, African-American, if it's white, if it's Asian-American, if it's a racially mixed community. Poverty is poverty. And I think that it's incumbent on policymakers, on leaders, to provide real opportunities so everyone can succeed. That's what the country really wants. They want a job. They want a sense of security so they can provide for themselves and their family. If my mother hadn't made that bold, courageous decision to come here, I surely wouldn't be sitting here today talking about what the future should be like for a great state like California.
And we're going to have to fight like never before.
My name is Kevin DeLeon, and I'm running for the U.S. Senate in California.
Senator DeLeon is the son of a single immigrant mother. He was the first in his family to graduate from high school and college. Senator DeLeon was elected by his colleagues to lead the Senate in 2014. He has led the 40-member Senate body to historic accomplishments that will improve the lives of Californians and the state's environment and economy for decades to come. In many ways, Senator DeLeon embodies the promise of America. From a childhood of poverty to community activism to the upper echelon of the California legislature, his respect and commitment to working families and the betterment of all Californians has never diminished.
State Senator Kevin DeLeon placed second in the top two contests. That means the Democrats will face off on November 6th.
Each of us is shaped by our heritage, our community, our family. In turn, we leave a lasting impression on those we've touched. That's what makes a life. That's what makes a legacy. Celebrate your life your way with Glendale Funeral Home. Customized services that honor your memory, created to fit you. Glendale Funeral Home, how do you want to be remembered?
Spring Beauty Event, Saturday, May 12th. Preview the most exciting summer trends. Enjoy complimentary services all day and receive gifts. Your $25 reservation fee will be credited toward the beauty purchase of your choice. RSVP to 818-207-2211. Learn how to customize your own fragrance. Mark your calendar. Tom Ford Masterclass on June 9th with Caroline and Katrina. Every $100 you spend, you'll get $25 in rewards. Food, drinks, and gifts await you. For appointments, call 818-207-2211. International Families Association is a non-profit organization. Կազմակերպություն, որ տարիներ շարունակ ծառայում է ի նպաստ ցածր եկամուտ ունեցող ընտանիքների. Յուրաքանչյուր երկու շաբթի և չորեքշաբթի օրերին, կեսօրից հետո ժամը 2-ից 5-ը, տրամադրվում է անվճար ուտելիք և այլ ապրանքներ. Ընդունվում է ամեն տեսակի հովանավորություն. Մանրամասների համար զանգահարել 818-770-0779 հեռախոսահամարով։
Սոնաֆե տարեցների առողջապահական կենտրոնի հարևանությամբ գործում է All for Health, Health for All բժշկական 8-րդ կենտրոնը բժիշկ Ջանոյանի ղեկավարությամբ։ Ինչպես միշտ, բժիշկ Ջանոյանը շարունակում է սփրել իր պրոֆեսիոնալ բժշկական խնամքը տարբեր համայնքներում։ Ժամանակակից սարքավորումներով հագեցված այս բժշկական կենտրոնից կարող են օգտվել բոլորը, ինչպես նաև Սոնաֆե տարեցների առողջապահական կենտրոնի այցելուները։ Առողջ մարմին, առողջ միտք, սա է ապահովում All for Health, Health for All բժշկական կենտրոնը։
Անկասկած աշխարհի լավագույն սուրճի բերքը ստացվում է Հարավային Ամերիկայում։ Այնպես որ պատահական չէ, որ բարձրորակ հայկական սուրճը հանդիսանում է Հյուսիսային Ամերիկայի Jayco Coffee-ին։ Սուրճի բուրմունքը եւ թարմությունը պահպանվում է էֆեկտիվ եւ որակյալ ձևավորված հատուկ տոպրակներում։ Jayco Coffee, թարմբոված համեղ սուրճ, բարձրորակ փաթեթավորում, մատչելի արժեքներ։ Կարելի է գտնել բոլոր հայկական նպատակներում կամ հեռաձայնել 818 621 3003 հեռախոսահամարով։
For advertising on Insight TV, please call 818-653-0199.